Tell us what you need to know ahead of the Indian 2019 election. Take a look at the sheer numbers behind this event, starting with the total voter base that stands at a hefty 900 million, of which nearly half, that's 48%, 430 million, and this is an important number, are women. Historically, voter turnout has been higher among women than men, and hence some say they could influence this year's election result. The election will take place over 38 days, that's over a month, with full results being announced on May 23rd. Constitutionally, the new government has to be in power before the end of May. So who are the main protagonists of this mega election? Well, mainly there are two. There's the current Prime Minister, Narendra Modi of the Bharatiya Janata Party. He came to power in 2014 with a sweeping majority in a massive anti-incumbency wave. He will go head-to-head against Rahul Gandhi, leader of the opposition and the head of the Indian National Congress, which suffered a crushing defeat 5 years ago. Is that it, you may ask? Well, not quite. Next are the wild cards and the influencers. There's a rise of a third option for voters, the SP-BSP alliance. Economists polled by Reuters don't see them as a serious threat to the big parties, but they could swing votes in the battleground state of Uttar Pradesh. And then there's Priyanka Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi's younger sister. She made her formal entry into party politics in January this year and could be a major influence with women voters this election. Now, what are they fighting for? 543 seats are up for grabs in the lower house of the Lok Sabha, that's India's parliament, and parties need to hit 272 to claim majority and form a government. Early opinion polls show that the Congress, with its allies, will do better than it did in 2014, but that the BJP and its allies, that's the NDA, will come through with a slim majority to form a government second time around. Now, what does all of this mean for the markets, you may wonder? Well, a quick look at historical returns during past election years shows that equity markets have given very strong positive returns, provided that the outcome is that of a stable government, coalition or not. So as we kickstart our coverage of the big Indian elections, the key question to answer is really, will it be a vote for continuity or a vote for change? And we will know that only on May 23rd. So it's a bit of a wait, Jeff, but what is May 23rd, right, when you are dealing with October 31st?